Hello students, this is our next session in the chapter Atoms, and in this session I am going to discuss a few more numericals on the chapter Atoms. So look at the question. So if frequency of the series limit of Balmer series is nu 1, look at the question. If the series limit of the Balmer series is nu 1, so frequency they have given, wavelength they have not given. The frequency of the series limit of the Balmer series is nu 1, and frequency of the series limit of Paschen series is nu 3. If frequency of the first member of Balmer series is nu 3, then what is the relation between the frequency nu 1, nu 2 and nu 3? So this is the question. What is the question? What is the relation between a frequency nu 1, nu 3 as well as nu 2? How to find the relation? So first you try to understand the question. So what they have given? Frequency of the series limit of Balmer series is nu 1. So how to find the frequency nu 1? So for series limit, so which is the series limit of Balmer series? Obviously, the series limit of Balmer series, n1 is equal to 2 to n2 is equal to infinity. And you know that one simple empirical formula, 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. So what is the relation that connects the wavelength as well as frequency and speed of the light? So that is c is equal to nu lambda. So therefore c by lambda is equal to nu. So hence this 1 by lambda can be replaced as what? This 1 by lambda can be replaced as that simply r into c into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. So this I told in my previous video also. So what is the equation for frequency relation? The frequency relation nu 1 becomes r into c 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Here n1 is known, n2 is known. For series limit, what is n1 I told? See, for Balmer series, n1 value is 2 and n2 will be infinity. So therefore nu 1 you are going to get. In the same way you find nu 3. Nu 3 is equal to what? R into C into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Here value of n1 and n2 will be varies because the series limit of Paschen series. So Paschen series is nothing but the what? The third spectral series of hydrogen atom. It results due to the transition of electron from higher orbit to the third orbit. And even they are telling not the first member or any particular member here. So they are mentioning here the member is series limit they are mentioning. So what is the limitation of the series means? Infinity to 3. So infinity to 3. So that is the condition. So n1 should be 3 and n2 should be infinity. And nu 2, what is nu 2? Frequency of the first member of Balmer series. So for first member of a Balmer series, for first member of Balmer series, what should be the condition? Transition from 3 to 2. Yes or no? So therefore, here n1 becomes 2, n2 becomes 3. With the help of all these equations, first find out what is nu 1, nu 2, nu 3. Then what relation you can establish by looking into the values of that nu 1, nu 2 and nu 3. So that they are asking in this question. So question is very simple. The series limit of Balmer series, frequency of the series limit of Balmer series is a nu 1, and frequency of series limit for Paschen series is nu 3. And if the frequency of first member of Balmer series is nu 2, then what is the relation between nu 1, nu 2 and nu 3? Question is, then what is the relation between nu 1, nu 2 and nu 3 we supposed to find for this. So therefore, in order to find this, so first we shall find what is nu 1. Very simple, just now only I told you how to find. So nu 1 is equal to nu 1 is equal to nu 1 is equal to r into c 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. What is this nu 1? Series limit of Balmer. Therefore, rc 1 by 2 square minus 1 by infinity square. That is 0. Therefore, nu 1 becomes what? Rc by 4. Yes or no? Call this equation number as 1. Next, find nu 2. That is nu 2 is what? Nu 2 is the first member of Balmer series. Therefore, r into c 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. For first member of Balmer series, what is the condition? Transition from n to 3 to n1 equal to 2. Transition from 3 to 2, first line, infinity to 2, last line, series limit. So nu 2 is equal to r into small c, speed of light it is, 1 divided by 2 square minus 1 divided by 3 square rc 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. So this is 5 rc by 36, nu 3. Call this equation number as 2. Next, nu 2, this is nu 2, this is nu 2, because for Balmer series first member they told nu 2. What is nu 3? Nu 3, frequency of series limit of Passion series. What is the limitations of Passion series? 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, nu 3 equal to rc into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square for a Passion series. And the limitation of that series, that is infinity to 3. Rc 1 by 3 square minus 1 by infinity square. This becomes Rc by 9. This is nu 3. Call this equation number 3. Once if you look at the value nu 1, nu 2, nu 3, what relation you can establish? Just you can apply your mathematical concept here to establish the relation between nu 1, nu 2, nu 3, just by going through the values of nu 1, nu 2 and nu 3. So nu 1 rc by 4, nu 2 5 rc by 36 and nu 3 rc by 9. Obviously nu 1 minus nu 3 is equal to nu 2. Yes or no? Nu 1 minus nu 3 is equal to nu 2. What is nu 1? Rc by 4. What is nu 3? Rc by 9. So what is Rc by 4 minus Rc by 9? That is nothing but 5 Rc divided by 36. Where is 5 Rc by 36? That is nu 2. Yes or no? So therefore, what is the relation between these nu 1, nu 2, nu 3 corresponding to the what? Series limit of Balmer series nu 1 and frequency of series limit of Passion series is nu 3. If frequency of the first member of Balmer series is nu 2, then we have nu 1 minus nu 3 is equal to nu 2. Yes or no? So this is a very simple relation we can establish between the what frequencies of the emitted spectral lines in the given condition of spectral lines. This is very important. So nu 1 minus nu 3 is equal to nu 2. Just you can go through this question. Very simple. They have given frequency of the series limit of Balmer series and Passion series. So frequencies they have labeled as nu 1, nu 3, and first member of Balmer series they have given nu 2. But generally they have given nu 1, nu 2, nu 3. But how to take the expressions for that? You know common formula for wavelength of the spectral lines. how to calculate the wavelength of the spectral line formula, use that equation, and just you modify that equation in order to find the frequency just by taking C is equal to nu lambda. C is equal to speed of light is equal to frequency multiplied by wavelength. With the help of this equation, even in my theoretical discussion also, while discussing frequency and wave number, I told you. So even though if you are not understood this, just you can go through that and try to solve this. So next problem we shall see. Very simple problems will be there. Even these problems will be asked, this type of problem, especially what just we found, no? This type of numerical, they will ask in the competitive type of examination. So just you can have an idea how to solve this type of question if they ask. So next question is, hydrogen atom from excited state comes to the ground state. It means the hydrogen atom already existing in an excited state. It is in some higher energy state, excited state. Hydrogen atom from excited state comes to ground state by emitting the what photon of wavelength lambda. We know that when an atom comes from higher energy state to the lower energy state, under that condition it emits a radiation having some particular frequency. Obviously it has particular wavelength. Emitted a photon of wavelength lambda. So during this condition it emits a wavelength lambda. If R is Rydberg constant, the principal quantum number n of the excited state is, from which state, what is the number of that state from which that hydrogen atom is coming to the normal state? Is it clear? There is a hydrogen atom. In hydrogen atom, the hydrogen atom is already existed in some higher energy state. Say that higher energy state is n. That higher energy state is what, n? Because they have not given the particularly which state. When an hydrogen atom jumps from excited state to ground state, it means from n state to ground state. Ground state means what? N is equal to 1. Or else n1 is equal to 1, say n2 is equal to n. When it comes from higher energy state to lower energy state, it is emitting wavelength lambda. It is emitting wavelength lambda. Then what is the quantum number? Quantum number means the orbit number. From which orbit number that hydrogen atom is coming? If R is the Rydberg constant, they are giving in this question, if R is Rydberg constant, then what is the principal quantum number of the excited state? It means we have to find N2 is equal to N, that N only we have to find. Very simple question. Very simple question. See, Hydrogen atom from excited state comes to the ground state by emitting a wavelength lambda. If R is if R is Rydberg constant, if R is Rydberg constant, the principal quantum number, the principal the principal quantum number n of the excited state is very simple question, very common question. See, hydrogen atom from excited state, it means hydrogen atom is staying in some excited state, it comes to ground state. While coming, it emits a radiation because Bohr's third postulate. So it emits a radiation of wavelength lambda. If R is the Rydberg constant, the principal quantum number n, it means from which orbit it is coming, that orbit number we have to find. How to find? Wavelength is there, Rydberg constant is there, normal state is there, excited state number. So therefore, which relation which connects all these datas? That is solution 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Here n1 is equal to 1, n2 is equal to n. That only we require to find, because principal quantum number n of the excited state, n2 is equal to n. n2 is equal to n. So therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 square minus 1 by n square. 1 by n square. Therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into, this becomes n square minus 1 by n square. This becomes 1 by, the 1 by lambda equal to R into n square minus 1 by n square. Therefore, multiplying lambda on both sides. What I will do here, I am going to multiply lambda on both sides. So therefore, multiplying lambda on both sides, what it becomes? Lambda into 1 by lambda is equal to R lambda n square minus 1 divided by n square. Lambda get cancelled, and this is n square is equal to R lambda into n square minus 1. N square minus 1. N square equal to R lambda into N square minus 1. So we can also simplify this as like this also. Hingadru madri, or else we can simplify. So this one, multiplying lambda on both sides, 1 is equal to, so lambda by lambda is equal to r lambda. This n square minus 1 by n square can be written as 1 minus 1 by n square. Yes or no? N square by n square is 1 minus 1 by n square. So this implies 1 is equal to r lambda into 1 minus 1 by n square. 1 minus 1 by n square. If you simplify this, you are going to get the answer that is n is equal to. So, ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಆನ್ ಬೋತ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಸೊ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಬೈ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಮ್ಡಾ ಇಂಟು ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಯರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವಾಯರ್. 1 minus 1 by n square, here lambda, lambda get cancelled. 1 is equal to lambda r 1 minus 1 by n square. And we need to find lambda here, the n here, so that n becomes, so if you simplify, n becomes square root of lambda r by lambda r minus 1. If you just simplify this, lambda r minus lambda r by n square, it becomes, this is all equal to 1. So if you simplify this, you are going to get this answer. N is equal to root of lambda r by lambda r minus 1. Very simple one, lambda r minus 1. How to find? In hydro, if hydrogen atom comes from higher energy state to normal state, that is N2 is equal to N2, N1 equal to 1 state, while coming it emits wavelength lambda, then R is the Rydberg constant, then find from which orbit, what is the relay, what is the number of that orbit, and what is that principal quantum number they are telling, means excited state number. So here generally excited state number we got in terms of wavelength Rydberg constant. Okay, so n is equal to root of lambda into r by lambda r minus 1, because here lambda is not given any value and r also not told to take the value 1.097 into 10 raised to 7, and even for this question he had given a 4 options, and among that 4 options, so this will be the correct option, but I am not highlighting the options here, just I am solving like a numerical problems, exercise numerical problem like. So answer should be this one, lambda is equal to n is equal to root of lambda, sorry, quantum number that n is equal to square root of lambda r by lambda r minus 1. Is it clear? Very simple problem. Next, please try to go through these questions, these type of questions. Solution is simple. Solution is simple, and even question also they have given very simple. Next, the ratio of wavelength of the ratio of wavelength of the wavelength of the last line of the ratio of wavelength of the last line of Lyman series and the last line of Balmer series and the last line of Balmer series is very simple. The ratio of wavelength of the last line of Lyman series, wavelength of the last line of Lyman series and the last line of Balmer series, what is the ratio of wavelength? Very simple question. Once again, we have to apply the same spectral series formula for finding the wavelength, that Balmer empirical formula, lambda 1 by lambda equal to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. By applying that equation only, we can able to get the solution here. Is it right or no? The ratio of wavelength of the last line of Lyman series. Which is the last line of Lyman series? Yes. For last line of Lyman series, what we have? N1 is 1, N2 should be infinity. Therefore, 1 by lambda L, because lambda Lyman, wavelength of Lyman series, R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. This is R into 1 by N1 square, 1 square minus 1 by infinity, that is 0. This is all R, 1 by lambda L is equal to R, or lambda L becomes 1 by R. Call this equation as 1. If you take reciprocal of this Rydberg constant, you will get the wavelength of first member. You know that you will get the wavelength of the last line of Lyman series. Sorry. So next, for a last line of Balmer series, what is the condition? 1 by lambda L, 1 by lambda B, wavelength of Balmer series, 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. For last line of Balmer series, what we have? N1 should be 2, N2 should be infinity. Therefore, 1 by lambda B equal to R into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by N2 square, that is 1 by infinity, that becomes 0. So therefore, 1 by lambda B is equal to 1 by 4, R by 4. Yes or no? Or lambda B becomes what? 4 by R. What they are asking? Ratio of wavelength of last line of Lyman series to Balmer series, last line. So therefore, lambda L by lambda B is equal to, what is lambda L? 1 by R. 1 by R divided by lambda B, 4 by R, that becomes R by 4. This get cancelled, 1 by 4. What is 1 by 4? 0.25. So lambda L by lambda B is equal to 1 by 4. So the ratio is 0.25. Wavelength of Lyman is 0.25 times of wavelength of the last line of Balmer series. Very simple solution. Is it clear? Very simple. Next question. See next question. If an electron in a hydrogen atom jumps from an orbit level n is equal to 3, n is equal to 3, to n is equal to 2, n is equal to 2, the emitted radiation has frequency. Then what is the frequency of the radiation emitted? Very simple. Very simple. See, when an hydrogen atom jumps from an orbit of n is equal to 3 to n is equal to 2, under this condition, what should be the frequency of the radiation emitted, they are asking. So therefore, here, n2 orbit, that is 3, n1 is 2, and they are telling that frequency. Very simple. We know that 1 by lambda, we know that 1 by lambda is equal to what? R into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. This implies, what is this lambda can be written as? So we know that C is equal to nu lambda, therefore lambda can be written as what? C by nu. So if I write C by nu here, that will comes what? Nu by C, and if I cross multiply it here, it will become nu is equal to R into C divided by 2 square minus 1 by 3 square. Nu is equal to RC 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. Nu becomes 5 RC by 36. So this is the answer, 5 RC by 36. Where R is Rydberg constant, C is speed of light, nu is frequency of the radiation emitted while making the transition from 3 to 2. Very simple question. Next question, what is the wavelength of the most energetic photon? What is the wavelength? What is the wavelength of the most energetic? What is the wavelength of the most, that is energetic photon emitted in Balmer series of hydrogen atom. What is the wavelength of the most energetic photon emitted in case of Balmer series of hydrogen atom? Question is very simple. I think you might be understood this question. What is the wavelength of the most energetic photon emitted in Balmer series of hydrogen atom? What is the wavelength? Energetic photon. Generally, in Balmer series, energetic photon, and that too most energetic photon. Obviously, for Balmer series, if transition takes place from 2 to, that is 3 to second, that is from third orbit to the second orbit, first member it become less energy difference, maximum wavelength. So we can't say it is the most energetic. Then which one will be the most energetic? Transition from infinity to 2. Transition from infinity to 2. So therefore, obviously, for most energetic condition, N1 should be 2 and N2 should be infinity. Therefore, 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. R into 1 divided by N1 square, 2 square minus 1 by N2 square, infinity square. 1 by infinity is 0, therefore 1 by lambda is equal to, 1 by lambda is equal to, and another one thing here, R value is given, 1.097 into 10 raised to 7 per meter. 1 by lambda is equal to R by 4, therefore lambda becomes what? 4 by 1.097 into 10 raised to 7. If you solve this, you are getting the answer. If you solve this, you are going to get the answer. You are getting answer 365 nanometer. Or else 365 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter you are getting. Both are one and the same. Either this one, either this one. Is it clear? You are getting 365 nanometer, or that is 365 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter. You are getting the 365 into 10 power minus 9 meter, and the 10 power minus 9 we can write it as nano. Is it clear? So this is nothing but the what? Wavelength corresponding to the most energetic. So most energetic means frequency will be more, wavelength will be less. So this is our today's class. So still you can go through still more problems if you are having a textbook, if you are available with any kind of competitive material. So with the help of this theoretical knowledge, try to solve those questions which are asked in the competitive examination. So if you have any doubts regarding any of the concepts of this physics dealt with PUC second year, so you can ask when you will be entering into your offline class. So I hope that we shall soon meet in offline class, and thereby we can solve and clarify your doubts. Though also if you having any kind of difficulties while solving the numericals, so you can place your doubts and you can come to the college and you can ask your doubts to the respective staff. Okay, so with this, today's class I am going to complete with these few numericals. So further we shall see, if possible in our next class, we shall go through some few more competitive type of questions, and thereby we shall go through some new chapter. Okay, so thank you.